UPF and LPF for the function f of x is equals to x squared on the closed interval 0 to 1 and the partition consisting of the elements 0, 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4, 1. That is, the given interval 0 to 1 is divided into 4 sub-intervals. That is, 0 to 1 by 4 is the first sub-interval. 1 by 4 to 2 by 4 is the second sub-interval. 2 by 4 to 3 by 4 is the third sub-interval. And 3 by 4 to 1 is the fourth sub-interval. What are all given? We are given the function. The function is f of x is equal to x squared. We can take y equal to f of x is equal to x squared. And the interval is the closed interval 0 to 1. And the partition is P, which is the set 0, 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4, 1. We have to find LPF and UPF. What are the formulas of LPF and UPF? The lower sum of F with respect to the partition P is L of P, F, that is given as summation I equal to 1 to N MI into delta I. Here N is equal to 4 because we have 4 sub intervals. Similarly, the upper sum of F with respect to the partition P is UPF is equals to summation I equal to 1 to N capital MI into delta I, where I is from 1 to 4 because N equal to 4 here. What is the graph of the function y equal to f of x, that is equals to x squared? This is the graph of the function y equal to x squared. We know that y equal to x squared is a parabola passing through the origin. Now let us trace the graph. This is the graph y equals to x squared. Let us trace this graph. See, it is passing through the origin and it is going See the graph of y equals to x squared. That was the graph of y equal to x squared. Let us consider x axis and y axis. This is the origin 0, 0. Now here the given function is y equal to x squared. And we are given the partition P consisting of the points 0, 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 2 by 4 is nothing but 1 by 2, 3 by 4, 1 is nothing but 4 by 4. What are the sub intervals? The sub intervals are I1 is from 0 to 1 by 4, I2 is the closed interval 1 by 4 to 2 by 4. I3 is the close up interval 2 by 4 to 3 by 4. I4 is the closed sub interval from 3 by 4 to 1. So these are the 4 sub intervals I1, I2, I3. These are the points 1 by 4, that is 0.25, 2 by 4, 1 by 2, that is equal to 0.5. This is 3 by 4, 0.75. This is 1. Now, these are the 4 partition. This is the first partition. This is the second partition. This is the third partition. This is the fourth partition. What about the length of the first subinterval? The length of the first subinterval is the difference between the endpoints. That is 1 by 4 minus 0. It is here. 1 by 4 minus 0 is 1 by 4. So this is the length of the first subinterval, namely delta 1 is equal to 1 by 4. Now what is the length of the second subinterval I2? The length is defined as the positive difference of the endpoints. That is 2 by 4 minus 1 by 4, that is 1 by 4. Therefore, delta 2 is 1 by 4, delta 3 is also 1 by 4, delta 4 is also 1 by 4. Because the points are equidistant and hence the length of each subinterval is equals to 1 by 4. Delta 2 is equal to delta 3 equal to delta 4 and each is equals to 1 by 4. Now let us find the values. Since we are given Cartesian points, namely 0, 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4, 1. Now we have to find the value of these Cartesian points, because those values only will give infimum and supremum of each and every subinterval. Now, this is y equal to x squared is a function. This is x, this is y, y value is x squared. Now, when take the first partition point 0, when x is equal to 0, 0 squared is 0. Next partition point is 1 by 4. When x is equal to 1 by 4, what is f of 1 by 4? That is f of 1 by 4 is 1 by 4 whole squared. That is 1 by 16. The third partition point is 2 by 4. Now what is f of 2 by 4? F of 2 by 4 is 2 by 4 whole squared. That is 2 squared by 4 squared. That is 4 by 16. The fourth partition point is 3 by 4. So x is 3 by 4. Then what is y value? Y is f of x. What is the x? 3 by 4. Therefore, f of x, that is f of 3 by 4, is equal to 3 by 4 whole squared. That is 3 squared by 4 squared. 3 squared is 9, 4 squared is 16. Therefore, 9 by 16. The last partition point is 1. When x is 1, what is y? F of 1. What is that f of 1? 1 squared. 1 squared is 1. So, these are the points, namely 0, 0, this is 0, 0. Then 1 by 4, x value is 1 by 4, y value is 1 by 16. X is 2 by 4, y is 4 by 16. X is 3 by 4, y value is 9 by 16. X value is 1, y value is 1. Now we are going to represent these points in the diagram. Since we already mentioned 0, 0, the next point is x value is 1 by 4. What is y value? 1 by 16. That is the value here. This is from 1 by 4 to 1 by 16. The next point is 2 by 4. What is y value? 4 by 16. Look at this. This value 4 by 16 is nothing but 1 by 4. The third one is 3 by 4. Whose y value is 9 by 16. The fifth point is 1. When x is 1, what is y? 1. Therefore, 1 comma 1. Now the required curve, namely y equal to x squared, is a parabola which must pass through all these points. This is a graph passing through 0, 0, 1 by 4, 1 by 16, 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 3 by 4, 9 by 16, 1 comma 1. Now what is the problem? The problem is to find the area of the region under this curve and bounded by this x-axis and the point 0, 0 and this line. First, let us find the lower sum. To find the lower sum, we need to find the infimum of each and every subinterval. Now let us find the infimum of the first subinterval, namely I1. So what is infimum of I1? For this, we have to consider first sub-interval, the part of the curve is from here to here, and the interval I1 is 0 to 1 by 4. Because of infimum, we have to consider the least value, namely 0. Hence, we have to fill this region with the x-axis up to 0. That is nothing. There is no area at all. It's nothing but just a straight line. No area. And hence, small m1 is the infimum of the first subinterval, that is equals to value of the function at 0. That is f of 0, that is equals to 0, that is equal to 0 by 16. What is infimum of I2? To get infimum of I2, consider the second subinterval. The path of the curve is from here to there. We have to evaluate this region. For this, we have to fill this region with rectangle from x-axis up to 1 by 4, because 1 by 4 is the least value, up to 1 by 4. Then what is infimum of I2? That is small m2, that is equals to the value of the function at 1 by 4, that is f of 1 by 4. What is f of 1 by 4? F of 1 by 4 is 1 by 16. And hence m2 is 1 by 16. We will find infimum of the third subinterval. The third subinterval is the interval 2 by 4 to 3 by 4. Now this is a region, and the part of the curve is from here to there. We have to fill the region with rectangle starting with the x-axis up to this point 2 by 4. 2 by 4 is nothing but 1 by 2 up to this point. Then what is the infimum of I3? That is small m3. What is small m3? Value of the function at the starting point of I3, that is f of 2 by 4 or f of 1 by 2. F of 1 by 2 is 4 by 16, that is 1 by 4. 1 by 4. Let us find the infimum of I4. For this, consider the fourth subinterval, which is closed interval 3 by 4 to 1. This is the subinterval. Consider the part of the curve. The part of the curve is from here to there. We are going to fill this region with rectangle starting from x-axis up to the least value 3 by 4. Where is 3 by 4? Here is the 3 by 4. Then infimum of I4 is small m4, that is equals to the value of the function at 3 by 4. That is f of 3 by 4. F of 3 by 4 is 9 by 16. Thus, the infimum of the four subintervals, namely I1, I2, I3, I4, are 0, 1 by 16, 4 by 16, 9 by 16 respectively. And remember that infimum for an increasing function always give the value of the function at the first point of every interval. Four. What is the supremum of I1, the first subinterval? The part of the curve is from here to here. As we know that I1 is from 0 to 1 by 4. Supremum is always the value of the function at 1 by 4. Therefore, we are going to fill the first subinterval with the rectangle from x-axis up to the point 1 by 4. Then what is supremum? That is denoted by capital M1. Because the interval is I1, let us denote it by capital M1. What is capital M1? Capital M1 is the value of the function at 1 by 4. That is, the value of the function at 1 by 4 is 1 by 16. Therefore, m1 is f of 1 by 4, that is equal to 1 by 4 whole squared is 1 by 16. What is supremum of the second subinterval? I2. Coming to the second subinterval, the path of the curve is from here to here. How do you get supremum? This is the interval I2. It is starting from 1 by 4 to 2 by 4. Therefore, we are going to find the area of this region. For this, we have to fill this region with the rectangle that starting from x-axis up to 2 by 4, that is 1 by 2. Yes, 1 by 2. Now, what is supremum of I2? That is capital M2. What is capital M2? Capital M2 is supremum of I2, that is the value of the function at 2 by 4, that is 1 by 2. When f is 1 by 2 or 2 by 4, then x squared will be 4 by 16. 4 by 16 is 1 by 4, that is capital M2. Coming to the third subinterval, we are going to find the supremum of third subinterval. This is the region. The part of the curve is from here to there. Now the interval is 2 by 4 to 3 by 4. Therefore, we have to fill this region with rectangle from x-axis up to the point 3 by 4. That is up to here. Up to here, that is y value is 9 by 16, x value is 3 by 4. Then what is supremum of I3? Capital M3, that is equal to value of the function at 3 by 4. Because this is an increasing function. And we know that for every increasing function, the supremum is the value of the function at the end point. F of 3 by 4 is 9 by 16 and hence M3 is 9 by 16. Now, supremum of I4. How do you find supremum of I4? Supremum of I4, you have to consider the interval 3 by 4 to 1. That is, we are going to fill this region with rectangle starting from x-axis up to this point. Yes. What is capital M4? Supremum of I4. Therefore, capital M4 is equals to F of 1. What is F of 1? 1. And hence, M4 is 1. Thus, capital M1 is 1 by 16. Capital M2 is 4 by 16. Capital M3 is 9 by 16. Capital M4 is 1. That is, the supremum of intervals I1, I2, I3, I4 are 1 by 16, 4 by 16, 9 by 16, 1 respectively. Now we have to find lower sum and upper sum of the given function y equal to x squared with respect to the partition P. Lower sum, upper sum, we are going to find. These are the values of infimum of each subinterval. These are the values of supremum of each subinterval. And we all know everything is given. Now let us calculate the lower Riemann sum and the upper Riemann sum. First, let us calculate the lower Riemann sum. What is the formula for lower Riemann sum? Lower Riemann sum, the formula is L of P comma F is equal to sum I equal to 1 to N Mi delta I. Here N is equal to 4 because we have 4 subintervals I1, I2, I3, I4. Therefore, N is 4 and hence sum I equal to 1 to 4 Mi delta I. Now we are going to expanding this, that is keep I equal to 1. We get M1 delta 1 because we have the summation, namely sigma, we have plus, then I equal to 2, M2 delta 2, I equal to 3, so plus M3 delta 3 plus I equal to 4, M4 delta 4. We know all the values. m1 is 0, m2 is 1 by 16, m3 is 4 by 16, m4 is 9 by 16. And delta 1 is equal to delta 2 is equal to delta 3 equal to delta 4, each is equal to 1 by 4. Therefore, substitute all these values here, we get small m1 is 0, small m2 is 1 by 16, small m3 is 4 by 16, small m4 is 9 by 16. Now 1 by 4 is a common factor. Therefore, take 1 by 4 out. When you take 1 by 4 out, we get 0 plus 1 by 16 plus 4 by 16 plus 9 by 16 into 1 by 4. In the denominator, we have 16, 16. Therefore, simply add the numerator. That is 9 plus 1, 10. 10 plus 4, 14. So 9 plus 1 plus 4, that is 14 by 16 into 1 by 4. 14 by 16 is nothing but 7 by 8. And hence, 7 into 1 is 7. 8 fours are 32. Hence, it is 7 by 32. That is the lower sum of the given function y equal to x squared with respect to the given partition. Now, let us find the upper sum. What's the upper sum? U of P comma F is equal to sigma I equal to 1 to 4 capital M I into delta I. Now, put I equal to 1, then 2, 3, 4, we get the formula. Also, we know all the values. Capital M1 is 1 by 16, capital M2 is 4 by 16, capital M3 is 9 by 16, capital M4 is 1. And delta 1 is same as delta 2, same as delta 3, same as delta 4, and each is equals to 1 by 4. Substitute these values. When you substitute these values, we get M1, 1 by 16, M2, 4 by 16, M3, 9 by 16, M4, 1. Here, 1 by 4 is a common factor. And hence, we are going to take 1 by 4 out. Yeah, we are taking 1 by 4 out. Therefore, it is 1 by 16 plus 4 by 16 plus 9 by 16 plus 1. 1 is written as 16 by 16. The reason is, if we have same number in the denominator, to get the sum is simply add the numerator. Therefore, we write 1 is equal to 16 by 16. And hence, 16 is common. So, 1 plus 4 plus 9 plus 16. That is 16 plus 4, 20. 9 plus 1, 10. 20 plus 10 is 30. So, 30 by 16. 30 by 16 is nothing but 15 by 8. And hence, 15 into 1 is 15. 8 fours are 32. And hence, upper Riemann sum is 15 by 32. Thus, for the given function y is equal to x squared, with respect to the given partition, the lower dot box sum or lower Riemann sum is 7 by 32. Upper Riemann sum or upper dot box sum is 15 by 32.